the Joker and the thief, I said. I'll tell you all the story about the Joker and the thief, I said. I'll tell you all about the Joker and the thief in the night.
Okay, so I'm going to ask you a few questions about Year 12 because they're leaving soon, as you know. What are your thoughts on Year 12?
Pretty scary.
Pretty smart.
They're really tall.
I think they're pretty good. I think they're pretty nice.
Yeah, they're decent. They're good.
Pretty.
They seem nice.
They're really nice. They're quiet in the playground.
Yeah, because they're studying a lot.
Yeah.
What is the most memorable moment you have with them?
Dancing.
Probably beating them in basketball, I guess.
When they were doing hurdles at the athletic carnival, they would always go under the hurdles.
Fame, probably, for me.
Playing soccer with the U12s when we were in Year 7, against the U12s, so that was fun. Yeah.
They were Year 9.
Oh, well, when they were in Year 9, yeah.
At the swimming carnival, when they were swimming.
Had they left a mark on you? And like, have they left a legacy to the school?
I don't know.
It's really hard because we know like two Year 12s.
No, not really.
Not really.
They leave a smell.
I think they did leave quite a legacy.
And do you have any messages or anything for that for when they leave?
We love you.
Yeah. Good luck.
Good luck and don't do drugs.
Don't do drugs.
We hope
don't
they
screw up.
Yeah.
That's a good one.
Have fun. Don't fail university.
Have fun in life.
Work hard even after school again.
And we hope that they achieve all the stuff that they've started to work towards in Year 12.
Find a good marriage person. Have fun and good luck.
One question for you, Jaden.
What is this?
Ooh, back. This is the moment. Tonight is the night. We'll fight till it's over. So we put our hands up like the ceiling can hold us. Like the ceiling can.
just going to ask you a few questions about year 12. So I'm going to ask you a few questions about year 12.
Wait, put it back. Put it back. It's too close.
Answer as honestly as you can, okay? Most memorable moment you have in year 12?
Most, no, there's been plenty of those.
The most memorable moment?
Year 12.
Can I look at the questions first?
Definitely year 11 camp.
Making chocolate magnums with my year 12 food tech class.
Year 7 camp.
Any stories? Any?
No, I can't remember.
I don't know that we've had memorable moments. My class is really tough. They're horrible, horrible people. I'm in therapy over this lot because they're really, really hard to work with. They're a big class and I'm not sure, you know, how I'm going to get through the next couple of weeks, but I'm sure it'll be okay.
When I took your year group to the snow and Riley knocked himself out.
Borat. Right.
We decided to play a black comedy version of Space Jam, which ended up being quite hilarious.
Getting to finish our final English text for HSC.
Certainly the School of Origin series.
Having our Year 12 Textiles class all hand in their major work by the due date was very memorable.
I can't remember.
Oh, probably Crossroads Camp last year.
The swimming Clyde Hall.
I do have several amazing memories. One being with a said gentleman, Mr. Curley, in the hall, dancing with the Year 7s, impromptu dance.
My balloons when they celebrated my birthday.
In Year 7, and there was a guillotine in the room, and I was conducting demonstration, and one person hit the guillotine pedal, and he passed out.
I think for my guys, laying the slope for construction.
Year 10 Geography 2016.
And the last 2 days of school, you painted my room.
Graduation, woo!
Using three adjectives, describe the most annoying Year 12 with no names.
Relentless, fidgety, and very chatty.
Loud, phone user, and a little, no, generally annoying. I'm not going to tell you, Nick Ford.
Talented, lazy, wasteful.
Confident.
Most annoying Year 12. Collectively, they're annoying.
An absolute punish.
Loud. Obnoxious. Disrespectful.
Persistent.
Well, annoying is obviously the first one. Then I'd say apathetic and frustrating.
Annoying, clingy, and needy.
Irritating, disturbing, and aggravating.
Most likely to succeed.
Oh, easy. Abby Sim.
Sol. That everyone in Year 12 has the potential to succeed.
Oh, somebody had a Miss Attenborough's PE class, I think.
I have no choice, I'd have to say Mel.
Go with Jackson.
Amber, yeah.
Either Lance Van Der Veen or Lauren Novacek.
Matt McVeigh.
Have they left a legacy on the school?
Yeah, I think so, definitely.
Yeah, they definitely left a legacy.
Every group leaves a legacy on teachers, school, and the junior students.
Entertaining.
Okay. Oh, most definitely.
I think so, every year 12 does.
Yeah, predominantly good.
The cohort absolutely has left a legacy.
Describe the cohort in one word.
Enthusiastic.
Awesome. Endearing.
Enthusiastic.
Excellent.
Fun.
Fun.
Funny.
My children.
Rowdy.
Excellent.
Legendary.
Memorable.
Interesting.
Extraordinary.
Yeah. Awesome.
Great game.
Sometimes I get to feeling I was back in the old days, long ago. When
when we were kids, when we were young. Things seemed so perfect, you know. The days were endless, we were crazy, we were young. The sun was always shining, we just lived for fun. Sometimes it seems like lately, I just don't know. The rest of my life's been just a show. Those were the days of our lives. The bad things in life were so few.
I'm going to ask you a few questions about Year 12.
I just want you to answer them as honestly as you can.
What is your most memorable moment?
Probably when Zalia stacked it up the stairs and got stuck and could not get up.
Oh, Mr. Key.
Mr. Key.
The Year 9 camp was pretty eventful.
Riley dying at ski trip.
It's going.
No, I'm getting out of this.
No.
For myself was going up for the speech for sport captain. And I basically called myself an elephant in front of the whole grade, and it was great.
When I got knocked out at grade sport.
Year 11 camp, definitely.
You had a strawberry milkshake and I came up to you and I hit it out of his hands thinking it was empty and it went on both of us, so it was embarrassing for both of us.
Yeah,
that was...
I threw a stick at someone's head and she had a concussion.
Breaking my wrist in year 7.
When Talia wet her pants in the change rooms.
It wasn't a lot.
Time in PE where Regan threw the water bottle at the fan in the fan broke.
I'm a fan with the farms.
copping the W against Jaden in basketball. Like,
because when we had a lockdown and the guy we were meant to be hiding from, I was talking to him.
Don't work up from fainting in year 8. Hi, Miss Battistella.
It's 126 negative incidences.
Canteen brownies.
We love brownies.
Fame at the farms.
Probably getting a milkshake at the old canteen on the first day of school.
I painted with Craglietto.
Damo broke in the door in maths.
Probably the multicultural day.
He rode the cow and let's just say it didn't end well.
Probably handball during the 3 periods.
We're making more memories!
Funniest moment.
Every day lunch is the funniest moment, bro.
Definitely breaking Millie's ankles.
Again, ankle breaker. Everyone loved that one.
Did nearly her whole body in like over 3 lessons.
When me and Maya were, this is in year 11 camp as well, Mr. Puglia filmed us singing the song of Frozen.
When I passed out at the peer support thing in the middle of the hall.
We were putting bits of liquid nitrogen into a Coke bottle and throwing them and they would explode. Except this specific one, it didn't explode straight away. So I approached it.
Put in cheese and mix it.
Oh bro, the food fights at lunches.
I've completely like fallen and slid down block 7 stairs.
No, when someone pooed in the bathroom on year 9 camp.
Yeah.
When Harrison Conroy was sleeping on the desk and we threw a highlighter lid at him and he woke up slowly with drool just dripping everywhere.
I tried the front flip, banged my head on my knee and came to school with a black eye.
Licking a match into the bin and accidentally setting it on fire and then to putting it out.
Best excursion, favourite excursion.
I barely went on excursions.
We went to like some zoo thing.
The bio excursion.
Luna Park.
Oh no, definitely ski camp.
The driving one.
Luna Park one.
Yeah, 9 camp.
When we went on the boat.
When we went to Piermont and we went on a river cruise and somebody jumped into the water.
Geography excursion.
Year 10 one on the boat?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ooh, that was awesome. And we even got the added entertainment of someone jumping in the harbour.
When Lucas Naylor jumped into Darlingmont one.
Yeah!
Lucas jumped into the lake.
Year 7 camp.
I think everyone already knows why.
Yeah, so. Ski trip.
Ski camp.
Yeah, year 11 camp, that one. That was pretty cool.
Favourite year? So like what was your favourite year 7, year 8, year 10, year, you know?
Now.
10, 12.
Year 8.
Year
that
7.
Was my top.
7 or 8. Oh, year 10 you were pretty bad.
Year 10. Or
year 10.
No, year 10.
Year 10, like.
Yeah.
Just say. No, it actually was year 10. Year 10 was heaps good.
I reckon you're 11.
And what do you want to do when you finish?
A design course.
Ooh.
Anything in the sports industry?
Mechatronic engineering. Ooh, biomedical engineering masters.
The next Chris Brown vet.
Can I be a rock star?
I'll go to university, I guess. Study engineering, for something like that.
Yeah, go to university studying IT.
Character design in Japan, specifically.
Schoolies.
Services, because I like helping people.
Tattooing.
Design.
Event management.
Real estate.
To open my own arts and crafts shop.
I want to go to film school.
To become an electrician, to be honest.
Do a business course.
Music production and psychology university.
Zookeeper.
Carpentry.
That's cool. And describe the whole experience of high school in one word.
Easy.
A mess.
Unpleasant.
Unpredictable.
Memorable.
Okay, so my final message to year 12 is, firstly, good luck in the HSC. And good luck for the rest of your life. Be happy, successful, make your life purposeful. And if you do come across tough times, I hope we've taught you enough resilience here at school to get through those tough times and just be successful at whatever you do. That's it. Good luck, everybody. Bye.
Tonight, I'm gonna have myself a real good time.
time I feel alive. And the world, I'm turning inside out, yeah. I'm floating around in ecstasy, so
don't stop. Having a good time.
I'm a shooting star leaping through the sky like a tiger, defying the laws of gravity. I'm a racing car passing by like Lady Godiva. I'm gonna go. There's no stopping me. I'm burning through the sky, yeah. 200 degrees, that's why they call me Mr. Fahrenheit. I'm traveling at the speed of light. I wanna make a supersonic man out of you.
Don't stop me now.
I'm having such a good time, I'm having a ball.
Don't stop me now.
If you wanna have a good time, just give me a call. Collision course, I am a satellite, I'm out of control, I'm a sex machine ready to reload, like an atom bomb, about to
explode.
I'm burning through the sky, yeah. 200 degrees, that's why they call me Mr. Fahrenheit. I'm traveling at the speed of light. I wanna make a supersonic woman of you.
Don't stop me.
Ooh.
Don't stop me. Don't stop me.
Have a good time.
Don't stop me.
Oh.